I love this game for a multitude of reasons. Firstly, you can play it at 3 o'clock in the morning and you won't get bored. Secondly, the soundtrack to this game is absolutely phenomenal. And thirdly, because it is ultimately a relaxing game to play. So today, we'll just be having a quick look at some of the things that you can do in Universe Sandbox. It's recently been updated, so I thought I'd just try out a few of the features I'm familiar with and a few of the features I'm also familiar with. Righty then. So one thing I was thinking of doing was, if you click on Earth, there we go. If you click on Earth, you can change a number of aspects about it, for example. So along this side here, you've got the mass, you've got the radius, you've got the density, you've got the age, surface temperature, you've got the speed, the rotational period. So what I was thinking, that we could mess around with a few of these. For example, if we get a bit close to the planet, slow things down a little bit. So yeah, currently this is at 7 minutes per second is the time frame we're in at the moment, which of course it makes a lot of sense. The Earth doesn't usually rotate at this speed. If it did, we'd probably be flying off it. So if we increase the surface temperature here, oh there we go, and immediately you can see the ice caps have more or less disappeared. So if we just bump it up again a few notches, there we go. That's quite interesting. So you see Greenland up here has now completely barren of snow, and a few of the more shallow areas around the Americas have also started to lose a bit of water. So let's see what else has been affected. The Earth is currently has an average temperature of 63.3 degrees centigrade, which of course realistically would be absolutely catastrophic, seeing as the Sahara Desert only gets to 50s, I think, but I'll have to brush up on that. So if we speed round to see my home country of England, here we are. So the English Channel has been evaporated, more or less. Africa looking very, very dry. I think that's the sea that runs in between there. I might be wrong, but it's drying out. So if we keep on bumping up the temperature, so now the average temperature is 121 degrees. So the entire area around Britain is now completely void of water. Most of the other seas are starting to have serious chunks of water taking out of them. Basically just seeing the Europe shelf here that's retaining a bit of the water. Up north actually it's incredibly dry. But things really get exciting when things start to melt. So if we keep on bumping up the temperature, oh there we go, 692 degrees. Most things are combusting at this point. The Earth is there's a little bit of water there. Could be what that is, but it must be very, very deep in order to retain that water. For some of you noticed there's little specks flying off here, and basically that's mass. That's the evaporating mass of the Earth as the atmosphere boils off. So yeah, there's barely any water left now, and in fact the continents are looking pretty dried out. So if we just increase the temperature again, the surface temperature has actually dropped quite a bit, probably because of the excess mass it's losing. The water just disappeared. There you go. Right. So if we just bump it up a little bit more. Oh, the Earth has turned into a fiery, glowing ball now. Lots more mass is starting to be lost. If we actually have a look at the mass, Yeah, it hasn't actually changed an awful lot. I think it's just the atmosphere that's been destroyed, but that will change as we get hotter. So about 1,000 degrees centigrade at the moment. We do have the moon simulated at this point. It's not changed its orbit. There is a cloud of the once atmosphere surrounding the Earth. And you can see the lighting of the Earth. Well, it's glowing embers now. Alright, so if we up on the Earth and bump the surface temperature up to 2,000 degrees. Yes, so Vok is more or less molten now. And well, I don't think you'd have much chance of surviving anything at all at any depth on this Earth. Not that you would have much chance at 600 degrees. So if we bump it up to, for example, 5,000 degrees, ooh, we're now white hot. It's quite sore in the eyes, but you can certainly tell how hot it is. At a certain point, the moon will begin to get affected by this excessive temperature. So if we bump it up to 10,000 degrees now. Right, we're now at blue hot. I'm not sure what the surface temperature of the sun is, actually. I will have to check that. But I know that the sun doesn't glow blue, so I'm not quite sure if we are now hotter. So let's go 20,000 degrees. There we go. Okay, there's lots of mass being lost now. In fact, we have now lost the mass of the moon. We've completely evaporated into thin air. I couldn't tell you the physics behind that. What I can probably assume is the particles inside the Earth vibrating so much that they no longer could attract each other anymore, and the Earth becomes gas, or at least tiny dust particles. Of course, now that the moon has lost its course, its centre of, well, its central body that it's orbiting around has now been turned into gaseous form. So I'm presuming the moon will just carry on in a straight line. Yes, flying away, quite helpless to its location now. The moon, of course, looks very good in this. Now, if you... I'll just reload the simulation. We'll have a look at some of the other effects that we can do. Of course, another thing you can do in Universe Sandbox is blow things up, which is very exciting, of course. You can launch astrological bodies at, well, other astrological bodies, and cause absolute mayhem, which I adore. Okie dokie. So, if you've ever been wondering what happens if Mars were to collide with, well, Earth, what effect that would have on the Earth, and what effect that would have on the Moon. So if we just slow time down, otherwise this might pass quicker than we can look at. So if we slow down to more or less standard time, let's put it about here. Now, one quite exciting thing you can do in this new update, I do believe, is if I press C and I can look up, move along, I've lost Mars, where's Mars gone? If I just line this up, and now I look up, oh wow, yes, okay, that's quite daunting. Quite an ominous sight. If we speed up this slightly, we might even... Oh, no. Ah, yes, of course. The Earth rotates, which causes problems for this type of viewing. So now we're moving about a minute per second. And if we keep on looking down, the Mars will actually collide with the Earth as we're looking at it, which would be pretty amazing to see. Slow, 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 slow. get too slow. It's going to touch the horizon. Here we are. Not many seconds. I can't actually tell if we've had contact or not. Here we are. The atmosphere of Mars is thinly touching ours now. We just speed this up. 1,000 milliseconds per second. We should have always be standard time. We'll have a look still. Oh, come on. Too slow, come on. Oh, touch. There we go. Wow. So, Mars is slamming itself into the Earth. It's quite a sight. Energy that was produced. Now, you'll have to forgive my computer at this moment, because this is obviously quite a complex simulation. And for a Pentium CPU, that could be problematic. But you can see the fragments ricocheting away and recolliding with Mars, actually. Oh wow. So of course, the heat from the explosion is sweeping across the Earth, wiping out the water, of course. So you can see this dry patch around the explosion. We're moving at 3 seconds per second here. We'll speed this up a tad. Still, what a hell of an explosion. Wow, what's that fragment doing now? Spinning itself into a frenzy. Oh wow. So Mars has pretty much sunk in, or half of it sunk into the Earth at this point. Wow. Okay, if we just speed this along. Wow, huge chunks of Mars. Ooh, that's an interesting graphic. This game is still in development, and I'm not sure what the glowing orb is supposed to be. Oh, it's actually burying itself back into the Earth and producing more fragments. Well, they've certainly updated the in physics here, because this is quite spectacular. Wow. Oh my god. The detail they put into this is incredible. Ooh, a small explosion there. I'm not sure if that was an astronaut or people panicking with nuclear warheads. I suppose at this point it and the water's disappeared. Worrying, of course, when that happens. A little bit disturbing. From the southern parts of Africa, having a small wave here. Obviously, not caring about the catastrophic damage done to the other side of the Earth. On the Americas, actually. Britain is drier than it ever has been. So we just speed this along. Oh, and the red orb is now covering the Earth. Completely disfigured it all with the impact. So I want to see what this looks like when it all cools down. Of course, you'd think the moon would have changed orbit a bit more. I think it's slightly more elliptical. Because of course, when the mass is gained onto the Earth, there'll be more of a gravitational pull at that particular moment, which would of course, oh look, it's wiggling, an effect I've not actually seen before. That's the pull of the moon having an effect on the Earth as it moves. But anyway, I don't think I will make a series out of this. It was just a quite an interesting look at it. And I love the soundtrack. So I hope you've all enjoyed today's episode. And thank you very much for listening. Good night.